and thank you to those of the public who have stayed. I appreciate, you know, it's a long evening, there's a lot to go through before we get to the agenda item that you're most interested in, but we are now moving on to agenda item 8, community asset transfer, out of business planning stages, in your packets pages 65 to 76. So we've all agreed beforehand, there is an exempt, a couple of appendices that are exempt papers. You know why they're exempt. There's community groups that have put forward, you know, a lot of detailed information here. It's quite right, it should be exempt. But if you feel we can't have a good debate and come to some conclusion on these recommendations without referring to them, speak now, because it will be difficult to move the exemption once we get into it. So we're all pretty happy to proceed. So in that case, I think we have, thank you for coming to see us, Shepherd. I think we have Cher here to present this report and David Balls with us as well. Thank you.
Hi Chair, evening members. So I'm the SRO, the Senior Responsible Officer for the Community Asset Transfer Project, and I'm presenting in that capacity this evening. So the Community Asset Transfer Project came into force following an amendment to a budget proposal, which was agreed on the 28th of February. Which was to explore the transfer of 9 libraries, 2 golf courses and a leisure centre, as these were no longer affordable for the council and the functions no longer required to be provided. As it's established in the report, and as highlighted in the report, there was a two-stage process established. Stage 1, which was the submissions of expressions of interest from community organisations, and the outcome of that was presented to this committee on the 16th of June. And Stage 2, following that committee approval in June, the submission of 4 business cases by the community organisations, and that closed on the 25th of August 2022. I would say the work and the timescales to ensure the project progresses by the deadlines for the library closures on the 31st of October has been very tight, so on Monday. And as a result of this, the report only brings forward recommendations for the transfer of the library assets this evening. The recommendations for the transfer of Brighton Golf Course and Woodchurch Leisure Centre will be brought to the committee at its meeting on the 1st of December. And then the recommendations for the transfer of Hoylake Golf Course will also follow once the proposal has been considered alongside the arrangements for the Open Golf Championship, which you've also heard about tonight. And the latter 3 assets of those have remained closed since the 1st of April 2022. So in terms of the libraries, business cases were submitted for 7 library transfers. And in the process of the review, all of the organisations have been contacted on some of them on numerous occasions and have since been advised of the recommendations the committee is in. In addition to the project team review of the business cases, an external organisation called Seacombe was also commissioned to undertake an independent review. And what I'd like to do, Chair, is just summarise the outcome of those reviews, those business cases and the recommendations for the committee. So, first one, Penderby Library, in theory, a straightforward recommendation to transfer the asset to Pioneer People. Brenton Library, recommended to transfer the asset to St. Stephen's Church, but because the asset is owned by Magenta Living, and discussions have already taken place with Magenta Living, and some further dialogue will be needed with them just to ensure that the transfer arrangements are taken successfully. Woodchurch Library recommended to continue with discussions with Positivity and the school about the use of the asset, and the asset is an integral part of the school, and the option is for the school to retain control of the asset and to enter into agreement with Positivity directly. The business plan submitted by Positivity is not viable, but as the building would have remained empty with no further planned use if the asset wasn't transferred, the option of the school entering into an agreement with them could directly facilitate its continued use. Irby Library recommended to explore 3 separate options with the Friends of Irby Library, as the original business plan submitted by them, the whole site wasn't viable. One option would be for the partial transfer of the site, which would be the library building only, which would provide potentially a more viable option, and a revised business case would need to be submitted and reviewed if they wanted to do this. If this option is still not viable, then other options will be considered to seek alternative use of the site, and that would be potentially for commercial or residential purposes. Higher Bevington Library is recommended to be removed from the community asset transfer process as is, but to explore educational use of the asset with the Co-op Academy, who have submitted a business plan for the transfer. The business plan as it was wasn't viable, and it wasn't actually in line with the community asset transfer proposal. But one option would be to transfer the asset to the academy, but specifically for educational purposes and not for community purposes. We've asked them to submit a revised business plan with the inclusion of further funding sources to be able to facilitate this. If that second business plan is still unviable, then it's recommended that the asset is demolished, as no other questions of interest came from community organisations, and as a result of that, the land will be returned to the public for open space. Hoy Lake Library recommended for the Life Tree to work with other organisations to submit a revised business plan. Again, the original business plan as it was unviable. But we have asked them to work with other organisations that would look to potentially bring the additional income and to reduce the costs, the running costs, which then may result in another viable business plan. And again, if this second business plan is proven unviable, it is recommended that the asset is marketed for commercial use. And then finally, Wallasey Village Library, who it's recommended that the Friends of Wallasey Village Library and St George's School should resubmit the business plan after it was deemed unviable in its current state, and they have actually already suggested further options that could result in a revised business plan being submitted. Again, if this business plan is unviable once it's reviewed again, the asset will be marketed for commercial use. Just in terms of the report, in section 4, this provides details for the committee of the value of each asset and the cap of the costs associated with the investment required, which members need to take into consideration when taking the decision. And there's also an analysis of the bids submitted for the capital and revenue funding that we made available to support the library community asset transfer process. So that just provides a summary, Chair, the reasons for the recommendations, and myself and David are here at the committee of any questions. Thank you.
Sorry, I need the cost rate because it's moving on. So the recommendations here are very detailed, 1 to 7, and they each have subsections as well. So what I would propose is we go through each one in just the order that they appear in terms of our questions and our debate, and then it enables us to take any amendments as and when they crop up. But I'm going to move these with an additional amendment, additional number 8 recommendation, which is that any surplus from the £500,000 capital and or the £282,000 revenue funds, which are shown in table 4.2, be reserved for the library element of any business plans involving the asset involving the transfer of Bromborough Civic Centre following policy and resources consideration of the asset strategy. Do I have a seconder to all 8? Councillor Johnson has seconded all 8. So that was an addition, and then we shall deal with the amendments as we go through. And so at the moment, if we limit our questions to the Chair and David about Pensley Library and Prenton Library. Any questions? So are we all happy to agree, item 1, Pensley Library and Prenton Library, which shares just described pretty straightforward. We agree by assent on that one. Great, thanks. Recommendation number 2 is entry to further discussions for a period of time ending on the 9th of December 2022 with the groups who have submitted business plans for the libraries at Wallasey Village, the Woodchurch and Hoy Lake, with a view to achieving a viable business plan for cash transfer. So do we have any questions about any of those libraries listed in number 2 for share or for David?
Chair, I know we were talking at the last meeting about the options of utilising skills from all the groups that are already involved in the CATS. Have we approached other groups to help people who've got problems with their business plan? Are we utilising those skills? I know you said you were going to do that, just wondering, have we done so?
Yes, Councillor Collins, we have done so, and there are ongoing discussions across a number of areas that are listed in this report.
Thank you.
Thanks, Councillor Johnson.
Thank you, Chair. I still have a question, really. We do these small groups, as we said before, can't necessarily produce strong business plans. So I just warmly encourage you to keep involved in the Chamber of Commerce and other organisations to help these groups, because they do need help. I'm sure they're very competent and able to run the organisations there afterwards, but writing a business plan does need extra additional assistance. So what more can we do with council to support them, but also with our associated bodies as well? I think that's a very important question that's still standing. Thank you.
Yes, and just to respond, Councillor Johnson, we are using all of the support that we can for these business plans and bringing in other groups as well who've got proven track records of community asset transfer. So we're trying to make these business plans obviously as robust and as viable as possible. It may not be possible in every case, but we're certainly going to give that a good go. And the discussions I've got ongoing this week and next should hopefully help to move us forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Smith.
Thank you. Can I just ask David, on the basis of, you know, what's happening in schools at the moment, and just this weekend, head teachers are saying that they, in secondary schools, there's going to be a £250,000 deficit already before we do anything, and in primary schools, £40,000 deficit. So I noticed on the one in, you know, Wallasey Village, we've got this school involved there, St George's, right behind the Bevington one. And that's, you know, not even taking into consideration the energy costs. I'm really concerned, you know, and particularly when you were saying that plans weren't always clear, really. And could you tell me on the Wallasey Village one, what other groups are you looking at? I'm not clear. It seems very vague to me, all this. You know, what exactly are we saying? I'm quite willing to say, let's look at it in more detail until December the 9th. What exactly are we looking at?
So, Councillor Smith, in response to your question, in terms of the asset transfers where schools may be involved or may be supporting that process, the issues that have been raised nationally, obviously, about the increase in staffing costs, energy costs and the like, we have had discussions about those issues as part of the ongoing process. We're very aware of that. In terms of other groups that we are talking to bring in, I wouldn't like to just name any of those in an open session within the committee, because obviously we've got discussions going on. But what I can say is that these organisations have a proven track record of successfully taking previous council assets and making those work. And they're willing to work alongside us and with the various friends groups to try and ensure that we have, you know, robust and viable business plans here. So all of those factors that you've raised are all being taken into account as we move forward.
Sure, can I just come back? And they're happy with the date of the 9th of December as the sort of final date to come forward.
Yes, I'm happy with the 9th of December because we're not working here from square one. So obviously we've already got a business place and a range of proposals that have been developed. It's a case now of revisiting those and looking to see where we can strengthen that business plan. And as I say, with the meetings that I've organised with the various groups over the next few weeks, then the 9th of December is achievable.
Thank you, David. Councillor
Ray. Just a very quick question, Chair. Are there any cost implications in this further delay to the 9th of December?
We will have some costs associated with sort of maintenance and security of the library premises when they close at the end of this month. But the report does cover an estimated cost of those and the funding source for them.
Okay, thanks, Ron. And thanks, David. I think you know, we're concerned about the spirit of community asset transfer as well as the technicalities. I think yourself and Simon have both kept lots of user groups, lots of friends of mine, and lots of board councillors up to speed with everything in your board discussions. So thank you for putting all the time into it. And the additional time, you know, it's about 6 weeks from today, I think it is, that we'll be writing for them, because you're right, it isn't easy doing business plan. And so many on the Seacombe scores, what more or less there and thereabouts, that they just really need to understand. If you look on a SWOT analysis at a threat or a, you identified a risk, then you have to look at a plan to mitigate it. And so I'm sure with your help, they'll be able to submit much better on the 9th of December. So in terms of item two, and all of the libraries listed in that, enter into further discussions for a period of time, maybe on 9th of December, with the groups of submitted business plans for libraries at Wallasey Village, Irving, Woodchurch, or Lake, with a view to achieving a viable business plan for community asset transfer. Are we all happy to agree that?
Yeah,
read that one by a sentence, okay, thank you. Number three then is based on number two, pursue alternative options, including sale and commercial leasing of libraries, for which our plans are not achieved. So this would be after the 9th of December, once another assessment has taken place. So in principle, we're now going to agree that you can have a next step after the 6 week plan. Is anybody comfortable with that, or do we have any questions for David or Shep?
Thank you. There are a number of organisations that I'm just thinking that if the ones that have put the name forward and it's been decided they're not viable, can they be opened up to other groups that have expressed their interest for these items rather than just giving them up or selling them off or disposing of them? Is that straightforward?
So where we have got expressions of interest, if you recall back to the 16th of June committee, we had a number of assets where there were multiple expressions of interest, and we decided to take one through for that. So in those cases where there were two or three that expressed an interest, that interest is still there. So we have an opportunity, should we not be able to proceed with the currently identified transfer organisation, we can move to the second one. So that gives us an option there. And there's nothing to stop other expressions of interest coming through from the community, either in support of what we've already got, which is what we're talking about at the moment, or if those are looking to remain viable, if there were other expressions of interest from the area, we could also consider those as part of the process. So all the options are open at the moment. What we just encourage is people to come and talk to us as soon as possible, but particularly from a ward member perspective, if you know of other groups and organisations that are happy to support a community asset transfer or are interested
into work on their business plan. How are we physically giving them till the 9th of December to work on their business plans, but the actual asset that may become then available, it's more of a technical question of would it need to be empty before the 9th of December, or why would we have to clear early?
Okay, I'll try and answer, but Andy may want to also comment on that as this is his service area. But the libraries are due to close at the end of this month. We tried to take a consistent approach to say that we will be clearing everything out of the libraries, because essentially those buildings then are going to be mothballed pending any decisions taken on transfer. We'll have costs of just maintenance, security and all the other things, and by removing all of these items, it will help us with that. Where there is a library that's still in discussion for transfer, but we've got Michael Lismas, we're going to take, as was explained earlier in this meeting, all of the items, in particular the fence, boots items that they don't remove themselves, and we're going to put them in safe and secure storage. And then if a transfer does take place when we've been through this process, then they will be able to access those things. And it's the council who will, remove those things and put them into that safe storage. I think that's right, Andy, isn't it?
Yes, Chair, that's correct. As you can imagine, when you're working to a deadline, we've adopted a programme management approach to closures, decant, and everything else to try and mitigate costs as much as possible. So that decant work will start post closure. It's already been planned in with other colleagues. So what was David alludes to, everything will be stored. In the case of these libraries that are in this process, and then if there needs to be a repatriation, let's call it at some point, then we can raise that as well.
Thanks for that clarity, because obviously some of the volunteer groups can't be hiring vans and moving things, and then they move in. So the answer that was given to the public question kind of applies in this instance where we've got an extension to the 9th of December. Did you want to move? Sorry, Councillor Burton, you have to pick first. Councillor Burton, Councillor Smith.
Just as you know, myself and Julie have an amendment to move, which relates to the Bennington Library, and depending on the outcome of that amendment, would relate to the recommendation 3 that we're probably discussing.
Yes, so your amendment that you circulated, thank you in advance, is on item number 6, and so you prefer us to come back to this where we haven't even named that library.
I prefer the amendment to be resolved first. I'm asking if that would be possible because the Brighton Library has been referred to.
So on the point 3 here in these recommendations, those specific libraries involved are all that we would be agreeing on at this point. And then we come on to item number 4, we can have questions around Bevington, and then we can have your amendment to recommendation 6, as it's said.
I'm not sure if I'm making myself clear because our amendment, if it fell, if it wasn't agreed, would then relate to the recommendation of the AFL.
Sorry, it's my understanding that it has its own separate recommendation. Do you want to just see if the order? So 6 would have amendments, and then we have.
Is Councillor Burton suggesting that if you had an amendment to the recommendation in relation to Bevington Library, yeah, 5 and 6, that falls? If you want to include Bevington Library in 3.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, I'm happy to park 3 for now, if you feel that even though Bevington's not named in that list, that we can't agree it, but it could have been added in. But let's move on then to, sorry, was that your question, Councillor Smith?
David, I'm not clear on this. So you've had an expression of interest today from Bevington, High Bevington Library, that would support or come in with the Co-op Academy. Going back to my original question, does that have to be in by the 9th of December?
And
not a formal expression of interest, so we're not reopening the process here. It's just that we have received information from two community groups in that area that they are interested in supporting the Co-op Academy transfer of I-Bevington Library, and that is what we're exploring at the moment to see if that is possible and we can make something viable which is currently unviable. So as we go through this discussion process around the unviable ones, again, if ward members are aware of community groups that could come in and help to strengthen this, we're not going through a formal expression of interest process, but we will talk to those groups and see if we can then get people working together to strengthen those business plans to make them viable, if that explains the situation, councillors.
And that has to be done by the 9th of December.
That is the date that we put in the report and are recommending to members. And the reason for that is that we don't want this to be an open-ended process. We need to allow sufficient time, of course, for all of this to be fully considered. But we felt we needed to put a deadline in there because we need to bring this process to a conclusion. And what we have in mind is that clearly when we get to the 9th of December, we'll review everything, and then with your consent, we will bring an update progress report with recommendations in it to this committee at the end of January, and therefore all the timings are set out so that we can meet all of those processes. And clearly we'll keep all members of the committee updated with our regular progress reports that we're giving on CAT as those things progress.
Yeah, just one further point. Yeah, I mean, obviously, it's up to us as well as elected members to reach out to the communities as we are, of course, and David, you and I have had long conversations, haven't we, about the project. But yes, so it's a difficult time, but as you say, it's up to the communities to come forward and something that can you know, put us in a better place for the future as far as these assets are concerned.
Okay, thanks. So just look at the time, it's 8:20. We do have a 9 o'clock, as you know, cut off point. If we can, you know, get through this rapidly, because we do want to hear about the libraries also as a separate thing. But so 4, 5, and 6 all refer to High Bevington. And the amendment you circulated back in advance is the amendment to recommendation 6. So is that something you want us to deal with now? Okay. The recommendation is pursue demolition of High Bevington Library and utilisation of appropriation as public open space if viable. If a viable business plan for educational use has not been submitted within the relevant timescales, and the relevant timescales as it stands would be the 9th of December. The amendment, you've all been, you've all had a copy, so thanks for circulating. And the amendment would be, if a viable business plan for educational use of High Bevington Library has not been submitted within the relevant timescales, to fully consider any other alternative options prior to pursuing demolition, and if any viable options are submitted, report back to the committee on the 25th of January 2023. So in actual fact, the amendment is looking for a much longer timescale than all other libraries have been given. So we'll take the debate on it first, well, if you want to move it and second it, and then we'll take the debate.
Prepared.
Thank you. So questions for Cher and David around that amended proposal.
Yeah, I'd like just explain the amendment a little bit. No other library. Is that okay?
Sorry?
Am I okay to explain the amendment now?
Yes, no, please speak for it.
Sorry. No other library is at risk of demolition. There's no other building where demolition is the proposal. It's a capital work out. And that's why that brought this forward, because it is being treated differently. And it
there's a carbon cost of demolishing the building and removing the debris. Financially, there's going to be a cost of demolition. We don't have that figure at the moment because officers have been putting their efforts into working with the school to get that bit to work, which is quite right. But if you're going to vote for the option at the moment, then you're voting for demolition, which will have a cost, and we don't know what those costs are. I've been told the building is unlikely to be demolished before the 25th of January anyway, so it's not adding any significant costs to have the amendment and to allow time for other options to come forward. I am optimistic that the cap will work out, whether that's with the school or with another group, or potentially both, because obviously the groups may not want the school or the building in school hours, and the other groups might want it at different times, so there is a possibility of working together. But as I said, no other library is at risk of demolition if the cap process doesn't come through. So what I'm asking for is that Highland Library is not at risk of demolition either, and that we have looked at other options. So in short, it's too good a building to lose. There are other options, so we should pursue those and not take a rash, drastic decision that can't be undone.
Okay. And so there's not something specifically wanted officers to clarify?
So I probably need clarification on, I think you mentioned there was no impact on the budget. Is that something, if we're suddenly seeing a date the 25th of January, and we were talking about we didn't have a budget for securing these buildings. Is there no budgetary implication?
Thank you, Chair. So, Councillor's right in that the building is proposed for demolition. If there is no viable business plan that would come forward from the new school by the 9th of December, it will be unlikely that we would be able to demolish the library between the 9th of December and the 25th of January. We would have to go off tender. So we would have to incur some holding costs of keeping the library, as a mothballing library as it is. So there will be some costs of that. That has been included in the financial indications already. And that will come from that will reduce the savings that were put forward as part of the library proposal in the budget setting in February. So those costs will be funded out of the budget contingency for reduced savings. So really the impact of keeping the library available until the 25th of January, there's no additional costs of keeping that library purely to explore another community asset transfer, because it would be unlikely that it wouldn't be demolished by then anyway, so we would incur costs anyway.
Okay, thanks. So the mitigation would be in the round when we really look at all of these libraries, because it was difficult to forecast what kind of mothballing costs there would be. So it's something we're going to have to deal with that within our current envelope, aren't we, of how that's managed. So that's the amendments that's on the table, proposed by Councillor Greer and Councillor Bird. Any other questions on it, or are you happy to go to a vote on it?
Clarify, essentially what you're suggesting is moving is that on 4 or 5, you're moving that whereas 4, 5 and 6 as amended by your proposal be moved. Because the 1.7 6 doesn't really make any sense.
Yes, I understand where comments are going. I think the problem we have here is amending 6 in terms of demolition is fine, but you put a specific date on, so that's an extension, that specific date, so that's a problem. So should we cover off 4 and 5 to make sure that we know about the covenant on the land and we know about the continued conversation, because you know Dave Borland and Simon Cameron have given a lot of an effort to liaise with the Clark Academy, and I know you're progressing that. So should we just deal with those first, 4 and 5, then we'll come to 6, is that okay? So recommendation 4 is enter into further discussions for a period of time ending on the 9th of December with the Clark Academy regarding the option of an asset transfer to the Clark Academy of High Bevington Library with a focus on educational opportunities, and number 5, recommend to Policy and Resources Committee that the site of High Bevington Library is appropriated by the Council for Education Purposes in the event that a viable business case for its use for educational purposes is established. and the matters related to government or land imposed by the human states is resolved. So on 4 and 5, do we have anybody that isn't in agreement with us agreeing with those? Because we're going to have to come back to 3 anyway. So we would like David to go into further discussions for a period of time, ending the 9th of December. He's already in discussions with the Co-op Academy. Then we would recommend policy resources that if educational opportunities, you know, in the event that a viable business case is established, that it goes as part of the big asset transfer policy, and then matters related to the covenant on the land imposed by LEQ needs also be resolved. So on matters 4 and 5, are you all happy to agree and assent? Okay, thanks. So we agree in a set of 4 or 5, which brings us to 6. You have seen the amendment, and I think we just need to go to a vote on this, do we? Yes, so it's proposed and seconded.
Amended. Sorry, I really am not clear on this, David. I know it's this, I mean, Dante here. So are you saying that it's impossible? This group has come into you today to say that they are quite willing to work with. So we need them until either the 25th of January for them to be able to put a case. Seems extraordinary to me. You know, when we're telling everyone else it's the 9th of December. I mean, I'm quite willing for the other groups to come in, you know, I'm delighted, you know, to want to be able to come in. But can they not possibly get their case in the next sort of 4, 5, or 6 weeks?
In terms of the discussions with the Co-op Academy and the groups I've referred to in answer to the previous question, my target would be to complete the business plan discussions by the 9th of December to keep it consistent with all of the other libraries that we've set out here in the report. And that, in my view, is achievable in terms of getting to an assessment position whether we've got something here that is viable or that is unviable, you know, and then we would take the next step. I think, if I'm understanding the discussion correctly, that what's being asked for here is if we reach the 9th of December and we have not got a viable business plan at that point, it doesn't stop any other community interest that there may be coming forward with a proposal for Higher Beddington Library, which if that did happen and it was viable, we would report it to the this committee on the 25th of January. And we're further saying that there would be no additional cost to that because we would not be able physically to demolish the building between the 9th of December and the 25th of January just because of the processes that we go through, you know, in terms of that, if that makes it clear. If not, please let me know and I will try again.
I think I'm clear, because it does look like an extension of process is being looked for. Sorry, it looks like an extension is being asked for by doing explicit. That is the date of the committee. That's currently in the calendar. It looks like that's an extension of the entire process. Could you just clarify, would we form part of the full asset strategy process and not necessarily the subset, which is community asset strategy process?
Yes, yeah, so what we're proposing here, following on from some discussion at the workshop, members raised that they thought this was more of an asset transfer rather than a community asset transfer, the education side of things, and still some community
can't assume they're all the same in all the other cases. This particular case, you're actually stating demolition as next step. So I do agree with them that it needs to therefore be given extra time accordingly, given I've never been there, I've never seen it, I need to go and have a look. It sounds absolutely lovely, but it sounds like the sort of asset that we do need to try and keep in Wirral, and we do need to try and fight for. So given additional time on the basis that number six, the very different clause from any others you're giving, I'm personally very much supportive of what they're saying. Thank you.
Okay, any more questions on it? Did you want to come back in? Any questions for officers, really, unless you want to speak to it again? Okay. But did you want to clarify something, did you? Because I think we all understand that.
I think it has been clarified now. It's not about giving any proposals into the school extra time. It's about making sure the building's not demolished. If that cap fails, because there is that leeway where, you know, if it's not going to happen, if nothing's going to happen until the 25th of January, let the groups come in and put their bits in.
Councillor, please.
Again, just to pause.
Okay, thanks. We have to vote on number six as amended. Everybody in favour, just an indication of hands is five, just to raise your hands. I think that's pretty unanimous then, yes. So had it not slightly been forceful about dates, I think we all would have wanted alternative options of demolition. But yes, that's been accepted. So we now go back to number three, and we will add that in to the process. So number three is pursue alternative options, including sale or commercial leasing for those libraries at Wallasey Village, Erlingwood Church and Dorhoynick, which viable business plans are not achieved within the timescale. And just to confirm, the timescale is the same. It's the same for all assets. It's the 9th of December, isn't it, for all assets. Are we happy to agree? Number three, by assent? Yeah. Number seven is present an update report on the progress of all community asset transfers and or asset transfers for future meeting of this committee, including A, the proposed heads of terms for the transfer of libraries to Pensby and Prenton, and B, any viable